Welcome back to Dark Souls 2 New Game Plus Lore Play Part 9 or so. Last time we spent about 4 weeks fighting the Ruined Sentinels. And rather than continuing with the Lost Bastille, we're now going to go somewhere else. We're going to deal this area.
Oh, hello there. This room is not as it's... And only... shall I provide...
Not really any interesting lore there, to be honest. We got all that stuff, haven't we? Yeah. You'll notice that she actually just put a key in that thing. So speaking of Lysia, actually, there's been quite a lot of comments on the video. Shush, woman.
May the power offer your...
Yeah. Whether or not she is the nameless usurper. Now, I was of the opinion that she wasn't, because, well, let's look at it logically. For starters, the nameless usurper is a nameless usurper, which suggests that he or she, I think it's a she, is trying to, or tried to, usurp the throne. But that doesn't really make much sense with Lysia, because she has no other dialogue, as far as I can remember, that relates to that. But even more than that is the fact that, Lysia uses a hell of a lot of miracles, whereas the nameless usurper only uses a knife, which Lysia is not holding. Now, the only evidence I've really seen to suggest they are one and the same is that they have the same clothes on, and that it does actually say in the strategy guide that if you kill Lysia, the nameless usurper will not invade. Which is pretty good evidence, and it seems like I was actually wrong, and, you know, she is, but... Dress worn by miracle-casting clerics belong to Lysia of Lindelt. While it's true Lysia dedicated herself to miracles, it's rare for anyone to pass through life without trouble. Even clerics aren't always who they seem. So, if she is the usurper, which at the moment it looks like she is, I'm going to say I think that's actually kind of bad, because from both lore and gameplay perspectives, it doesn't actually make much sense. Imagine if Lautrec invaded you and started blasting you with magic, and then he never uses magic in any other places. It doesn't make sense. But, okay. Maybe she came to this land... She's from Lindelt, right? And Lindelt was... They were waging war against the people here. So maybe it's something to do with that. I'll do a lore video on this series in the future, but of course, feel free to leave comments below. Let's talk to Falcon. Though, yeah, this guy is voiced by Laurentius, which I think is pretty cool. Fun fact for you. I think the voice actor's called like Andy Gathergood or something if you want to look it up yourself. But let's listen to what he's got to say.
The dark stirs. I see that the dark is sparked within you. My name is Falcon. I will trade with you. What do you need?
I don't think we really need anything you've got, man. I'll buy another one of those. Might as well have a million. He sells dark pine resin. Good stuff. Dark orb. Dark weapon. Might as well buy another one of those. And he sells Great Resonant Soul, which is insane! In the membrane. Resonant weapon I've never used, but I hear it's kind of good. No, I'll just buy it more.
These are for you.
His arm's flipping out. Yeah, I've already got that stuff, thanks.
Into the dark. This land lies closest to the dark. That is why I came here. This kingdom collapsed long ago. All that are left are either undead or hollow. Save a few misfits like myself.
So, is he implying that he's not undead and not hollow? Obviously he's not hollow, but he suggests that he's not even undead, maybe? which I find quite interesting.
I went to a great school in the south, but neither sorcery nor pyromancy appealed. I learned nothing. Nothing at all, but it was there that I happened upon the dark. It drew me in, the nebulous dark. Soon I was drawn to this land where dark runs deeper than anywhere else.
See, he seems to know exactly why he's here, whereas other characters, they seem to forget and such.
Hexes originated in ancient times. They were once a form of sorcery, but the practice was lost, then later rediscovered. Those devoted to Hexes are a lonely lot, but nevertheless, they give their lives to their art. Such is the fate of we practitioners of dark. What drew me to the dark? I do not know. Hexes are more than mere tools to me. I feel affinity and warmth, something universal, nostalgia even. Those who discover dark realize this, and they never come back. This land lies closest to the dark, that this kingdom, or the save it.
So, hush.
No matter.
It seems that, God, how to describe it? Dark magic is almost like an addiction to the hexes. Now, why do you suppose that is? Well, let's have a quick look at the first dark magic. Perilous affront to all life and banned in most lands. Now, as far as I know, sorcery is a manipulation of the soul, like soul arrow, soul spear, and all that stuff. Whereas, ooh, that's close. In contrast, freaky dust. In contrast, hexes could be manipulating humanity. Could be. I could miss that guy. Pointless. Never noticed that before. It's cool though. We have miracles which come from the gods, or well, from books and scrolls. Sorcery, hexes, and pyromancy. Damn, these guys. They were bad enough on the new game, now they're steroids, apparently. Let's get to the bonfire. Oh, right, yeah, I forgot about him. I do not enjoy fighting these guys, they're bastards. Screw you. I got parried in PvP the other day. I was not expecting it whatsoever. I don't think there's anything I really need up there. But you can go up there if you wish. Aw, he almost fell off. Come on. Douchebag. Crunched his nuts. His hollow nuts. Was it Epic Name Bro? I think it was. Mentioned that this, hang on, let me mess the bonfire quickly. This area right here is based on a real-life hotel, I think it is. Which I think is kind of cool. It's very spooky. See, the forest stretches off for miles. And I don't think we can really see anything from up here. Can't see Drang Lake Castle, all we can see is foresty forests. Well, we can see the undead purgatory. Earthen Peak must be off in that direction. Iron Keep, God knows how that works. Iron Keep is just like floating in the sky. But today we're gonna do... What are we gonna do today? Well, for starters, I'm gonna swap weapon to the Sun Sword plus 10. My trusty Sun Sword. I love it. One of my favourite weapons. You really did not hit me from there. My trusty weapon. Enemy ahead. Yeah, we're gonna go to the Undead Purgatory. Ooh. And we're gonna try... Oh, really? I can't believe I missed that. And we're gonna try and beat the Executioner's Chariot. It's kind of an easy-ish boss, but... It's one of those bosses where you can die a lot from stupid mistakes. If that makes any sense. Come on. Thank you. These guys can be a pain. But you can generally backstab them safely. Once they do that. Lots of health. Here we go. I wonder if you can parry them. I mean, you can probably parry them, but I don't know if you can riposte them. We'll do more, like the other... We'll explore the other stuff later. For now, we're just going to do the Purgatory. You know what I kind of dislike about Dark Souls 2? That you can't really farm high-level upgrade materials. I want to try and parry him. Fail! Gonna run and heal. Yeah, I don't think you can... You can't farm them and you can't buy them, which I don't like. I think you should at least be able to buy Titanite chunks. Twinkling. I mean, you can buy Titanite chunks at the very end of the game, like, after you complete everything. Oh, god damn it. I swear, they really don't want you to parry in this game. I mean, you can parry on weak enemies, but you don't really need to on weak enemies. Parrying strong enemies seems to be strongly discouraged, if you ask me. Might be I'm just not used to the timing, but... Well, who knows. We're gonna swap to Ring of Protection. I don't actually know why I'm using those. I don't really need to save my effigies or anything, but whatever. 666. An ominous sign. Give me that torch. Oh, hello. Backstabs can be... See, I don't know why I did that much more damage this time. Last time I did like 800 damage, this time I did loads more. Backstabs seem kind of freaky. Sometimes you do like double damage backstabs, and I have no idea why. I think that might be a glitch, but... No idea. No idea. I wish I could one-shot these guys. I could if I was using a stronger arrow, probably. These guys are pretty vulnerable to backstabs. They also do hit pretty damn hard, though. What? Okay. Whatever. I suppose we should talk about the lore of this place, shouldn't we? Oh! Ew, sneaky. Well, this is the the Huntsman's corpse, which in the olden times, they staged undead hunts here. Oh my. Oh. Yeah, they had undead hunts, which a lot more brutal, if you ask me, than anything that happened in Dark Souls 1. We didn't have undead hunts then, they were just like... Well, yeah, there were undead hunts, but it wasn't as brutal as everything seems to be now. You know, I actually forgot to speak to Gavlan Wheel, Gavlan Deal, Gavlan Miss. Oh! Whipman. Son of Whipman. You got poise? No, you don't. Now you got dead. But yeah, I think it was the old Iron King. He seemed to really... Hello? There's another one.
What is that?
Oh, that's a different enemy. Oh dear. That ain't good. Oh crap, he's fast. Oh dear. Running. Oh man. Oh! Yikes. I can't believe I pulled that many of them. It's insane. He's still following me? Stop. Whoa, he runs super fast. It's crazy. Look how. Ooh, they follow you insanely far. Oh, damn! He did have some hyper armor. Ouch. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Much pain. This summon won't really work, because I'm still uploading, yep. Damn, that really hurt. I wonder if it's even possible to pull them one at a time, because that really hurt. Alright, yeah, I forgot the... Oh, I can't believe he's still alive. Oh, come on. Really? Sheesh. Yeah, how am I gonna... Well, I've got a lot of magic arrows, maybe I'll use some of them. I hope you can pull them one at a time. If not, that could be a problem. I'm not the most durable of characters. I only have, like, 20 vitality. Which I think is generally enough, but... Or is it vigor? Oh, I don't know. Vigor, vitality... All that crap. Oh, hello, what'd you drop? Poison moss. Do magic arrows scale? I don't think they do. No, it just inflicts some magic-y damage. Let's see if I can one-shot him with it. Yes, I can. 459 and wooden arrow does. Not a huge difference, but you know it's better than nothing. Oh, too slow. Nope, made it. One thing I don't like is that they've made it so when you move diagonally whilst locked on, you're actually kind of slower than you were in Dark Souls 1. I don't really like it. I think it's a bit of a silly change. I think it's mostly because they wanted less circle backstabbing, but... A lot of the changes, I think... as much as I hate to use the word artificial difficulty, I do think some of the changes are artificial difficulty. Well, that was really good damage. Well, that was also a headshot, I think. Yeah. Like, great example of what I consider artificial difficulty. Enemies, bosses especially, that can one-shot you. That? No thanks. Ancient dragon, hello. God, how am I gonna do this? Can I? Let's try and see what happens. Just one? Please say it's just one. Sometimes you can just stunlock enemies with headshots, which is really good. I love doing that. I did it so well yesterday. I was in someone else's game helping them. Just completely stunned an NPC. It was great. Backstepping's actually really good in this game. And by backstepping, I mean this. You can do it with your shield up. And doesn't take much stamina, it's great. You can have a taste of my bow. Hits like a great bow. I'm sure you remember too, if you've played. God. He's gonna one-shot me. I can probably cheese him with arrows. Should I? Just checking he's by himself. Let's see if I can... Yeah, I'm gonna poison him. It's not cheap, because my character is a bow character, so there. He's not got too much health. Oh, I can't see the gaps. Come on, lock on range. Oh! Damn. He seems to have slightly increased aggro range. I don't think I can poison him. Am I even hitting him with poison arrows? Yes, I am. Some people are calling this guy, like, Havel 2.0. He's not really, but... He's just a random character. Yeah, he seems to be immune to poison. That kinda sucks. No, he's not, he just has quite high resist. Not high enough, because he's now gonna die. Run! That is sublime boner dust, I think. Right, let's check. What do I need here? I don't think I need too much. You know, I'm summoning because it's going to be so laggy for this phantom. He's probably going to... like, get hit by something that's not there. I'm just kind of doing it to be mean. Right. You know what, I think I actually have everything I need. This is a pretty simple boss, to be honest. So let's do it! Summoning failed. Don't care. What's happening? I think you can actually make this guy fall down. Should we try it? I kind of want to try it. I ought to kill the skeletons first. Oh, right, crap, I need to swap shields. Because I'm going to be taking too much chip damage otherwise. Oh, move! Out of my way! Get out of my way! Why am I using an Estus? Ah! Where is number one? Here we go! Whoa! Oh! Bastard skeleton! Yeah, I didn't have enough stamina left, and they catch up with you, so... Oh snap! Oh my jeez, that was close. Oh my jeez! Come on! Oh, come on! God damn it! You know what, actually, there's no enemies hitting me here, is there? I want to try and see if I can just make the boss fall down. I've heard that you can just make him fall into the pit, and that's what I want to try and do. Can I see it from here? Yeah, I can see it from here. This could be... Plus, it would make me laugh if he fell in the pit. Can't quite catch him with one of the... If I was using a faster bow, I could probably shoot him then too. No, you just have to time it, alright. Alright, you just have to time it. Well. Haha, this is a pretty interesting way to do it. Maybe you just have to kill him all the way. I read somewhere that you can make him fall down into the pit if you hit him a few times, but it doesn't seem to be happening. Missed him that time. Horses are starting to freak out. Huh? What's going on? What the hell is happening? Is it bugged out? He's not moving. Okay. Let's see what he's doing. I bet he's gonna suddenly come charging around and squish me. That would make me very sad if that happened. Oh, crap, I still have my weapon. Oh! Damn! Surprise me. God, I hate these stupid skeletons. I just wish they would die when the necromancer died. Where is he? If the boss is like right next to him, that would really suck. What's going on? Any more skeletons? Horsey, what are you doing? Wait, 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 it looks like you're in a spot of bother. Well, let me help you out. Oh, very good indeed. Hello, Chloranthi +2. How fast is it now? Let's see. I can't notice any difference. I need to slow it down, actually. You know what? I'm going to do that. Right now. Let's do it with and without. Okay, there's a slight difference there, yeah. It's good. It's good. Right, I'll read his soul quickly, and then we'll stop. Soul of the Executioner's chariot, not the Executioner, but his chariot, that holds control over the undead purgatory. The chariot was created only to torment undead, and it took the form of a horrendous mad steed, a window into the soul of its master. Use the special soul of the Executioner's chariot to acquire blah-de-da. So yeah, this is more... I believe this was the Iron King who made all this nasty stuff. We'll talk to him next time, but... I need a break, because doing that run kind of made me tired, and I'm thirsty. Where's my damn shield? There we go. Okay, that's gonna do it. See you guys later. Tomorrow, in fact. Ciao. But whenever I fight them in PvP, I always make certain that I'm strafing to the side, and yet they still somehow hit me. Oh, he just spawned out of thin air. And that is not very nice. And he wasn't... Oh, that was really not very nice.